नमस्कार। दीज डेज कोरोना वायरस इज ह्यूजली इन द न्यूज। द होल ह्यूमैनिटी हैज सकम्ड बिफोर इट, बट लेट्स हैव अ मोर डिस्पैशनेट लुक एट द वायरसेस। इट्स नॉट एज इफ वायरस इज समथिंग न्यू। इनफैक्ट इट हैज बीन ऑन दिस अर्थ लॉन्गर देन ह्यूमन बींग्स, रादर बिलियंस ऑफ ईयर्स। दे जस्ट अटैक अस एंड दे इन देयर फाइट फॉर सर्वाइवल दे स्नैच थिंग्स फ्रॉम आर बॉडी। एंड द अटैक बाई वायरसेज इज ऑल्सो एज ओल्ड एज द ह्यूमैनिटी। वायरसेज, बैक्टीरिया, जर्म्स, माइक्रोब्स, दे ऑल कीप ऑन अटैकिंग अस। वी कैनॉट स्टॉप दैट। इफ यू हैव टू लिव इन दिस अर्थ, वी हैव टू बी ऑन गार्ड अगेंस्ट सच अटैक्स। And these are fought by our army, which is called our immune system. Our immune system fights them. Some viruses like coronavirus may be just too strong for your immune system. But a sad fact is that we have also weakened our immune system greatly. We have cut down the efficacy of our immune system by series of mistakes committed over several decades, in fact more than a century now. You see, what happens is that we have introduced chemicals into our food, our water and our air like as if it is something absolutely safe. So much of chemicals are going in that our immune system is greatly compromised. And a compromised immune system cannot fight against any such attacks. Only when it is super strong can it win over this war. As in the case of a neighboring country sending in terrorists, when this was pointed out to the then army chief General Bipin Rawat that a neighboring country has been sending the terrorists, so he coolly said, okay, it is their job, they should not do it, but we know they do it. It is their job to send them, it is my job to kill them and put them 3 feet under the ground. So our immune system plays the same role. We should strengthen it again, and this virus threat should be taken as a wake-up call. Now we should take a pledge that we'll strengthen our immune system by studiously avoiding chemicals. In our race for producing more and more food, we have started adding so many chemical fertilizers, insecticides, weedicides and pesticides into our daily life that our immune system is greatly compromised. So we have to be very, very particular that chemicals in our food, water and environment are greatly curtailed. Some years ago, you will remember that an international cola company was accused of putting some unacceptable chemicals in their product. So then what they did was that they produced the reports of the water available in the country. They said, your water itself has excessive quantity of chemicals. What can we do? After all, we have to depend upon the water that you supply us. Despite the best effort, chemicals come in. So we have to be very careful about how many chemicals we are ingesting. Not only in terms of foods and drinks, but also in day-to-day life. For example, all the perfumes and other body lotions, they have so many chemicals. So one has to be very careful about their use. But we tend to be so callous in this matter that leave alone adding chemicals to the food, we are also ruining our food itself. You see, what is known very well as junk food If you eat that, your body is bound to turn into a junkyard. And junkyard is notorious for mosquitoes and flies and other germs. So we are promoting the growth of such tiny creatures whenever we eat wrong kind of food. As if that is not enough, we are also pumping in millions of tons of effluents into our air from all the factories and other products. The chemicals are everywhere. Humanity has suffered that for long enough, but now it is the final wake-up call. A tiny little virus is destroying us. Right now the focus is on finding medicine for it, but in the long term we have to also concentrate on how to empower our immune system so that it can handle any such threat. So not only the chemicals, but this propensity for junk food has to be carefully curtailed. It's not as if these are absolutely new additions. These were used earlier also, but in very small quantity and on very special occasions. People used to have to wait for a birthday or a marriage or some big party to have that kind of food. But in the modern times, fast food has become your staple diet, and we end up eating so much of it. That is also playing havoc with our immune system. And as if that is not enough, we also pump in excessive quantity of chemicals through our medicines that we take. Even they add to our toxic overload. So these are the well-known factors. If the whole society wakes up, all the better. But we should at least make a personal effort to take charge of our own health. Instead of running scared of viruses, we should realize that we can conquer them merely by improving our immune system. So, eat healthy, eat right, and in right quantity. For example, when we talk about non-vegetarian food, as it is very heavy to digest. But if we take it in big quantity, then it becomes all the more burdensome. So all these factors have to be borne in mind. Not keep on appealing to cattle and other animals not to come into your courtyard. At the same time, raise the walls of your courtyard. And it is not difficult to do. Just don't eat things which are not made with ingredients which are only 3 or 4 in number. All the chemicals about whom you don't know much, they are either added to prolong the shelf life or to make it more irresistible. So we should be very careful about how much chemicals we use. As our quantity reduces, you will be able to tackle even such a serious disease as coronavirus. So be happy and be careful about your body and health, because this is the only chance you have. I'm sure you will put these suggestions to good use. Thank you very much.